Welcome, grade 2s. This is Mrs. Swanepoel, and today we are going to talk about woordsoorte. In Afrikaans and in English, it's called parts of speech. Reg, so ons gaan kyk na werkwoorde en selfstandige naamwoorde. We are going to look at verbs and nouns. Right, so let's start with werkwoorde. Verbs. Let's have a look at what these words are. Werkwoorde is doenwoorde. Verbs are doing words. Let's have a look at some of them. Sing, sing. Spring, jump. Dance, dance. Lees, read. Hardloop, run. Bou, build. Klim, climb. Skree, shout. Val, fall. Skryf, write. Slaap, sleep. Eet, eat. And then we have a few pictures at the bottom here. We have a little girl and sy is besig om te sing. She sings. Daar is 'n seentjie en 'n dogtertjie wat dans. A little boy and a girl dancing. Dan het ons 'n seun wat klim op die klimraam. We have a little boy and he's climbing on the jungle gym. En dan het ons 'n seentjie wat val. There's a little boy and he's in the midst of falling down. Let's have a look at a few sentences to see if we can find the verbs in it. Kom ons kyk na 'n paar sinne en kyk of ons die werkwoorde kan kry binne in die sin. Nommer 1. Die varkie bou 'n huis van strooi. Number 1. The little pig builds a house of straw. Ask yourself the question. What is the little pig doing? Vra jouself. Wat doen die varkie? Yes, that's right. The little pig builds. Die varkie bou. That means bou is die werkwoord. Builds is the verb. Kom ons kyk na nommer 2. Let's have a look at number 2. Die wolf klim op die dak. The wolf climbs on the roof. Right, so what is the wolf doing? Wat doen die wolf? Baie mooi. Klim. Climbs. Nummer 3. Die wolf hardloop uit die huis uit. The wolf runs out of the house. Nou vra ons weer. Wat doen die wolf? What is the wolf doing? Ja, baie mooi. Die wolf hardloop. So hardloop is die werkwoord. The wolf runs. So runs is the verb. Kom ons soek die werkwoorde. Let's look for the verbs. I'm going to give you a few sentences. I will read it in Afrikaans and in English. And then we will see if we can find the verb in each of those. Die klein varkie skop die bal. The little pig kicks the ball. Now you have to ask yourself the question, wat doen die varkie? What is the little pig doing? Die klein varkie skop die bal. The little pig kicks the ball. So skop is ons werkwoord. Kicks is the verb. Die klein varkie skree vir die wolf. The little pig shouts at the wolf. Die klein varkie skree vir die wolf. That means skree is die werkwoord. The little pig shouts at the wolf. What is the pig doing? He is shouting. So that means shouts is the verb. Die klein varkie hardloop weg. The little pig runs away. Die klein varkie hardloop weg. The little pig runs away. So hardloop is ons werkwoord. Runs is the verb. Die wolf sien die varkie in sy huis. The wolf saw the little pig in its house. Die wolf sien die varkie in sy huis. The wolf saw the little pig in its house. So sien is wat die wolf gedoen het. Saw is what the wolf did. Those are the werkwoord en verb in the sentence. Right, so now we have nouns, selfstandige naamwoorde. Selfstandige naamwoorde in 'n sin is iets wat ons kan sien en voel, soos 'n persoon, 'n plek en 'n ding. The noun in a sentence is something that we can see and feel, like a person, a place and a thing. Let's have a look at a few nouns. Kom ons kyk na 'n paar selfstandige naamwoorde. Kar, car, seun, boy, skoene, shoes, appel, apple, hospitaal, hospital, kerk, church, dokter, doctor, beker, jug, fiets, bicycle, skooltas, school bag. And then we have a few pictures at the bottom again. Kinders, children, school, school. And my absolute favorite, a little Dachshund, or a sausage dog as they call them. In Afrikaans is it a worshond. Now let's see, if we look at these pictures, what do you think they are? Remember we said a noun was a place, a person or a thing. Right, so if we look at kinders, what do you think kinders is? Yes, children are persons, a persoon. Let's look at school, school, what is that? A school is a plek, yes, a school is a place. And believe it or not, but an apple, the apple, of a worshond, is a thing. So we can't say a little dog is a person, it's a thing. So a worshond is a ding. Kom ons lees 'n paar sinne. Let's read a few sentences. Now when I read the sentence, I have to look for the things that I can see and touch. It's almost like playing a game where you imagine you can take that thing and put it right next to you so you can see it and touch it. Goed, nommer 1. Die varkie bou 'n huis van strooi. The little pig builds a house of straw. Goed, wat kan ek vat en sien? What can I see and feel? Die varkie bou 'n huis van strooi. Can I take die and put it next to me? Remember, die in English is the, not die. Die, no I can't. I can't put it right next to me. Varkie, pig. Yes, if the little pig is going to sit still, then I can try and put it next to me. Bou. Now that's something that I do. Builds. Now, I can't take a and put it right next to me. On its own, it doesn't have any meaning. Huis, house. Yes, I can imagine a small tiny house that I've got right next to me, or the house that you live in, you can feel it, you can see it. Fun, of, I can't take of and put it right next to me. Strooi, straw. Yes, I can see straw. I can touch it and I can even smell it. So in hierdie sinnetjie is varkie, huis en strooi selfstandige naamwoorde. In this sentence, pig, house and straw are all nouns. Kom ons kyk na nommer 2. Die wolf klim op die dak. The wolf climbs on the roof. What can I see and touch? Wat kan ek sien en voel? Mooi. Wolf en duck. Wolf and roof. Let's look at number 3. Die wolf hardloop uit die huis uit. The wolf runs out of the house. Write again. Wolf en huis. Wolf and house. Kom ons soek die selfstandige naamwoorde. Let's find the nouns. Now remember, a noun is a place, a person or a thing. It's something we can touch and see. Onthou nou, selfstandige naamwoorde is a plek, a persoon of a ding. Dit is iets wat ons kan sien en wat ons kan voel of aan kan vat. Die klein varkie wil 'n huis bou. The little pig wants to build a house. Let's think a bit. Which are the nouns? Watter is die selfstandige naamwoorde? Varkie en huis. Pig and house. Die wolf val in die pot. The wolf falls into the pot. Wolf en pot. Wolf and pot. Die eerste varkie bou 'n huis van strooi. The first little pig builds a house of straw. Varkie, huis, strooi. Pig, house and straw. Die tweede klein varkie bou 'n huis van stokke. The second little pig builds a house of sticks. Remember, we have to see it, we have to feel it, or maybe touch it. Good. Varkie, huis en stokke. Pig, house and sticks. Dankie dat julle saam met my kon leer graad 2's. Pas julleself mooi op. Thank you grade 2's for joining me again. And please take care of yourselves.